My name is Vinny. I'm a solutions engineer with CircleCI. And so CircleCI is a continuous integration tool, and our mission is to make it as easy as possible to go from idea to delivery. Where it sits in the tool chain, upstream, you have your you have your version control tools and services like GitHub, Bitbucket, etc. And then when you make a change and commit your code changes, what that does is it triggers a build on CircleCI automatically. And so we sit in the middle. We have customers automating us from the build process to various other miscellaneous tasks like actually deploying the code, building documentation, deploying documentation. We have customers doing security and code scans, linting the code. Various different tasks that you can automate. CircleCI can flexibly accommodate it. And then finally, downstream, once your code is tested, everything looks good, we deploy. And because of the way our system is architected, which I'll be showing you here in just a second, we can basically integrate with almost anything out there that has an API and is reachable via the internet. And so I guess showing you is better than trying to talk my way through it. And so really quickly, I'm going to walk you through a basic demo of the platform. It's not going to take more than a few minutes. This is a website that I have that I ripped off the Start Bootstrap template. And what I'm trying to do is deploy these static website files to an Amazon S3 bucket. Now, that's a very trivial use case. Not all use cases have to be this trivial, obviously. We have customers doing far more complex things. We have people doing mobile application builds on iOS and Android and then pushing to the App Store. We have customers who are rolling out new microservice updates to their Kubernetes clusters. There are lots more complicated and big use cases that are being done on our platform. It's just that for our demos, we choose to keep the use case simple so that the focus stays on the product itself. If I flip over to the GitHub pull request here, you can see on the pull request that my build failed, which is obviously a problem, right? And so as a developer, I'm going to click on the details, I'm going to look through this, and I'm going to see, hey, my test job failed, and subsequently these other two jobs were blocked. If I click on this link here, I am taken to what is called the job details page. And on the job details page, you are given the information that you as the developer care about. All of these other steps pass, and so they are closed by default. And so the actual portion that fails is expanded, and I am immediately given the information that I want. I can see the output, I can see the errors from the tests that failed, and these are simple assertion errors. Now, sometimes when you're doing CI/CD, as I'm sure some of you have experienced before, sometimes the bugs or problems or errors are not so obvious, and it's not easy to tell what's going on just by looking at the output here. And so CircleCI offers a unique capability to rerun a job with SSH. What this will do is it will secure your environment with the SSH key that's in your GitHub or Bitbucket, your version control system, and then it will rerun this same exact job, but then open that port so that you can get inside the environment, poke around the files, look at logs, etc. And we have found, as well as our customers have found, that it is a huge game changer for productivity and being able to debug jobs, essentially. And so I noticed that there was a question that popped up in Q&A. Just in the interest of time and to get through things, what we're going to do is I'm just going to go through the presentation, and then we can circle back to answering questions at the very end. Hope that's okay with you. So if we head up one level from the job details page, you are given the workflows page. And on the workflows page, you can see, hey, these are how the jobs are related to each other. And you can see that because test failed, subsequently these two other jobs were blocked. Now, the way that you configure this configuration on our platform is via a YAML file inside your repository. So on the right hand here, you can see the files and folders inside this repository. There is a .circleci folder here, and inside that .circleci folder, you've got the configuration.yaml. This is where you write the configuration for your jobs. And so here in the workflows definition, on the left-hand side here, you can see that I've configured a test, test parallel, and parameterized command. And these test parallel and parameterized command jobs require test. And that's how you configure the jobs and their interdependencies between each other. Now, you might have noticed that there are a whole bunch of other jobs here that are in the configuration that you don't see on the left-hand side. And that's because we offer the fine-grained capability to filter when you run certain jobs on our platform. Now, if I go down to the if I go down to the job definitions section here, you can see that all of these steps that you run and execute inside the configuration, they map one-to-one with what you see on the left-hand side. And so aside from a few special keys for a certain functionality on our platform, everything is configured with this run command. And this run command is just a freeform bash command that you can use to essentially run whatever command you want to. And so on top of defining the execution environment, we support all the major operating systems, we support custom Docker images, things like that. You can also configure the individual steps that you run within them. And because of this flexibility in configuring the environment and the steps you run within them, this is how we are able to support integrating with so many different tools and accommodate so many different use cases, etc. Quick pause here for anybody who's still looking. And so this configuration right here is special for CircleCI because it's also what allows us to integrate together with so many partners. And that is what our orb basically. Orbs on our system are going to be the integrations that we have with other partners. And all they are reusable, shareable packages of this YAML configuration. And the reason why this is powerful is because it's just YAML. And so if for some reason there is not an orb existing for a certain tool or integration, it doesn't mean that you're blocked. You don't have to sit down and learn a new language or learn new development tools. You just have the right YAML configuration yourself. And so it's not a blocking thing like it is on other platforms. Just an example here, you can see here in some of the configuration, you can template and reuse not just entire jobs, but also individual execution environments, as well as individual commands as well. And this is really great for organizations who are looking to standardize processes and steps across multiple projects or multiple teams and things like that. And so these orbs are what give us the ability to partner together with people like Lambda to give you convenient packaged YAML to integrate and use their tools. We have a lot of existing integrations. We have more than 60 internal maintained orbs by CircleCI. And then we have also a lot of partner orbs as well, and a total of more than 1,700 community orbs. And so there's a lot of great stuff out there for you to use. It's ready to go. Just kind of include it inside your configuration and then run it. So these are just some resources and links to get started with CircleCI, as well as more about orbs.
If you'd like to learn more, be sure to follow our blog at lambdatest.com/blog, as well as our Lambda Test community at community.lambdatest.com. You can also earn resume-worthy Lambda Test Selenium certifications at lambdatest.com/certifications.